Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 34th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 647.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 14th time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 35th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 8-1.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9, go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1081, then landed successfully for the sixth time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Later today, we can hopefully expect to see another mission launch. The Bandwagon 1 mission is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 7th at 11:16 PM UTC or 7:16 PM EST. Then, next week, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission. The Starlink 648 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 10th at 4 AM UTC or 12 AM EST. Later in the week, and we can hopefully expect to see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 649 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 13th at 1 AM UTC or Friday 12th at 9 PM EST. Related to the first Starlink launch we saw, SpaceX posted some information. They said 275th landing of a Falcon 9 rocket complete as the first stage safely lands on the A Shortfall of Gravitas drone ship. SpaceX posted some information about the Polaris Dawn mission and progress. It says the Polaris Dawn Dragon is headed to vacuum chamber testing. SpaceX teams celebrate Dragon's departure with the crew ahead of launching to orbit this summer. SpaceX also posted some information about what the crew will be doing during this mission. They said throughout their time in orbit, Dragon and the crew will reach the highest altitude flown in Earth's orbit since Apollo, test Starlink and conduct 35 plus research experiments in addition to the spacewalk. SpaceX's VP of launch posted some cool information about SpaceX's Falcon Q1 achievements. He said, just reviewed the Falcon and Dragon launch team's Q1 execution. The team set record in just about every category, Falcon, Dragon and fairing labor hours and cycle time. Launch to launch time on all three pads and all three drone ships. Two successful up-down astronaut missions for NASA and Axiom Space. First ever Dragon 2 launch from Pad 40 delivering cargo and research to the space station. Flawless execution on critical NASA and Space Force missions including Cygnus, Pace and USSF-124. 31 total launches and a 12 launch march demonstrating the necessary rate to hit our goals this year. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the expansion of Star Factory. Something was seen being moved outside Star Factory. Work also continues on the new office building. This payload section prototype was spotted out in the production yard. Elon Musk did a talk at Starbase about Starship a few days ago. SpaceX posted saying at Starbase, Elon Musk provided an update on the company's plans to send humanity to Mars, the best destination to begin making life multiplanetary. During the presentation, there was information about when SpaceX might try and bring Starship back to the launch site and reuse it.
And then there's recovering and reusing the ship. The ship will take longer. So the ship, I think we'll want to have at least two consecutive successes of a given design that land at a specific point in the ocean or smash into a specific point of the ocean before we try to bring it back to the launch site, because we do not want to rain debris over Mexico or the US. So my guess is probably next year is when we will be able to reuse Starship, but I think it's highly likely that this year we will bring Starship to, or the ship side of it, to a controlled point in the ocean, and have it basically land on a virtual tower in somewhere in the Pacific or the Indian Ocean.
Musk also gave information on their timeline for the first KSC launch pad.
We're aiming to have the first Cape launch tower and launch system operational around the middle of next year.
Some other information he gave was how many more vehicles they are planning to build this year.
So this year we're planning to build another roughly six boosters and ships. And that production rate will increase a lot next year.
Musk also gave a timeline on when they're planning to do a ship-to-ship propellant transfer demo.
And then next year, we're aiming to demonstrate ship-to-ship propellant transfer.
SpaceX posted this cool rendering of what a bunch of lunar starships on the moon could look like. They said with more flight tests, significant vehicle upgrades and missions, returning astronauts to the surface of the moon from NASA's Artemis program all coming soon, excitement will continue to be guaranteed with Starship. SpaceX also posted a super cool video of what a super heavy booster catch by the chopsticks could look like. They said the update included near-term priorities for Starship that will unlock its ability to be fully and rapidly reusable, the core enabler for transforming humanity's ability to send large amounts of payload to orbit and beyond. There was a cool picture from the presentation showing the size and stats difference between Starship version 1, version 2 and version 3. Version 3 will be substantially taller than V1 and V2. In response to a video about Starship's third flight test, Musk said flight 4 next month. During Musk's presentation, he gave information about SpaceX possibly trying to catch Super Heavy with flight 5.
And then hopefully be able to also do this with the booster. Land on essentially a virtual tower. If the landing on the virtual tower with the booster works, then we will actually try with Flight 5 to come back and land on the tower. Yeah. That's very much a success-oriented schedule, but it is in the realm of possibility.
Work was recently seen going on with Ship 29's heat shield tiles. Starship 30 was seen moved into Mega Bay 2. Recently, Booster 11 was moved to the launch site and lifted onto the orbital launch mount. Shortly after being moved, Booster 11 performed a static fire test. SpaceX posted this video saying static fire of the Flight 4 Super Heavy booster. They also posted some cool pictures of the static fire test. This booster 14 section was seen being worked on outside the Mega Bay. To finish up the video today, we'll take a look at the Cameron County website where there's some possible closures. The possible closures are for tomorrow, Monday 8th and Tuesday 9th. There are also temporary closures today, Sunday 7th and tomorrow, Monday 8th. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.